we expect them this year to collect about 1.5 trillion. Out of the 1.5 trillion, most likely they will collect 1.3 trillion based on the performance of the economy. Out of the 1.8, 1.3 trillion collected, we need 900 billion to pay for the external debts. That means you are left with about 400 billion. Out of the 400 billion, county governments need 316 billion. National government salaries require 600 billion. Operations in government and government entities require 200 billion. What does it tell you? We are in a deficit of more than 700 billion as a nation. And it means, as a nation today, we are borrowing to pay salaries. We are living beyond our means. In another 2-3 years, if we continue lying to ourselves as a nation as to the exact status of our nation today, we will sink this nation and we might find ourselves in the same situation other countries that I don't want to mention their names have sunk. So integrity and ethics demands that leaders speak to the issues in their country. And we hope that in not so long, the President of the Republic of Kenya and the leadership from himself down all the way to the members of the County Assembly will sit down and reflect on how we can be able to jumpstart the economy of this country so that we do not sink into situations that the other countries have found themselves in. I'm speaking this with a lot of heavy heart, knowing that we want to behave as if everything is normal, but that is not the case. We have a challenge and we have a problem in our country today. And somebody once said, if you find yourself in a ditch, even as if you do not have a mechanism of getting yourself out of the ditch, the best thing that you can do to yourself is to stop digging the hole further. If we are in a financial crisis as a nation, which is clearly the case, the best thing that we need to do as a leadership, let us not plunge the country into more financial crisis. Let us ensure that every small coin that we have is expended in the right direction and within the right interventions, so that then we can be able to save ourselves from this challenge. And therefore, with this kind of state of the economy, corruption should never be an issue to be discussed in our nation today. We should be able to ask ourselves, we do not have enough to even feed ourselves. Then why should we be able to have resources? How then can we have resources committed to corrupt activities? And I'm saying this not just for the national government, all the way to my government and all the way to every entity in our nation today. So as